This is my job.
On this episode of Dirty Jobs.
Look like you've been doing it your whole life.
Yeah.
Two very different families, two very different businesses, each one trying to carve out a slice of the American dream while making civilized life possible for the rest of us. First, I joined the brothers Boone.
Don't try this at home.
As we embark upon an epic quest to capture whatever the hell this is.
Lots of jelly balls.
Call them what you want. Here on Dirty Jobs, it's the catch of the day.
One, two, three.
This is the cod end of what we call a bag. This is where all the jelly balls are going to end up.
So when that thing comes up,
it's going to be full.
And somebody's going to come over there and grab that rope, and then it's going to open.
You.
When did the Boone family start fishing?
Four generations ago.
And who, that was your great-great?
Great.
Great? Sun's coming up in the east. Food's coming up to the south.
Oh, God. It's so bad.
And we are right on the cusp of having a ball.
Oh, see, look at it. That's a lot of jellies floating around.
Pull till you can't pull no more.
All right.
There's a lot of pulling on a jelly ball boat.
Tighten up every chance you get.
A lot of pulling and tugging.
Almost there.
All right, run until you block.
Did I mention the tugging and the pulling?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So what's all that tugging and pulling get you?
All right, don't let that thing roll towards you. It'd be unforgiving.
Don't let it roll toward me?
Uh-uh. All right, there you go. Now grab your long rope.
Now that, my friends, is a heavy smack. Once the work starts, you can see exactly how you're doing. It's called immediate feedback, and it's gratifying. And if you like the sight of 8,000 pounds of jelly balls slipping and sliding into a dark and dirty hole, then this, my friends, is the job for you.
So you get the idea. Nets go in, black sack fills up, hoist it up, empty it out.
Okay.
Wait 20 minutes, do it again. After that, what you do is you wait about 20 minutes, then you do it again. At which point, you wait another 20 minutes and then do it again.
So what's it like, man? You're the fourth generation of Boone to be in these waters.
In all honesty, it's kind of hard to describe, man. It's just the only thing I've ever done. It's all I know. That's how I've been in the ocean my whole life. I never really thought of doing anything else.
You love it?
You got to do it. Absolutely got to.
That's the truth of what's happening here. Yes, everybody is kind of exhausted, but nobody seems to care. The work never stops. The jelly balls make their way up onto this conveyor belt. From the conveyor belt, they fall into this bin.
Terry, I'm Mike.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you. This is your facility?
Yes.
Terry Lee came to this country with nothing. Didn't even speak the language, but he saw an opportunity and reached out to local fishermen to help supply a reasonably priced food additive to the Asian market. That was 30 years ago.
At the beginning, we only sell to the Japan, but in 2004, we start sell to the China. The quantity just wide open.
Really?
Yes.
Terry Lee is living proof that the American dream is still up for grabs. With a bow on the balls, we're off to Jacksonville, Florida.
We just make a little run and start there.
Where another family-owned business is waiting for me to help them grind it out on the floor.
All right, this is the restaurant. We're not allowed to tell you it's so when you hear me bleeped or when you hear anybody bleeping, it's not because we're using bad language. It's because we've used the name of the restaurant we're not allowed to utter.
For epoxy to bond on a surface, the surface has to be completely clean. In other words, you must first eliminate the dirt from the old epoxy floor before adding the new epoxy to the old floor in order to protect the new floor from the old dirt and to keep the new epoxy from cracking.
What's it called again?
This is a swing sander.
Go!
Whoa!
A massive resin grinder that'll prepare the floor for a new coat.
Ready?
Yeah.
This machine uses a powerful motor and grinding blocks with diamond blades to rip up the old epoxy. It also has a vacuum to minimize dust and maximize difficulty.
There you go, Mike.
Sorry, Ben. No time for pictures. Epoxy resin reacts with the hardener to create a durable surface. The trick now is to get the epoxy applied before it hardens. It's kind of like concrete. Once you pour it, it doesn't work for you. You work for it.
There's probably a good technique and a bad technique for this, right?
If you don't mind, could you go up to that next one? We got to kind of move along because we're getting to work.
Think you can teach work ethic?
Oh, yes.
I mean, how do you do it?
You know, you got to want to learn, you know. If you just come work for a paycheck, you're never going to like what you're doing. If you don't like what you're doing, don't do it.
Those cleats, by the way, are not designed to keep me from falling on my ass. They're designed to let me walk around without leaving footprints.
You got to get to the places nobody checks.
The last of the floor.
All right.